Hey guys, so as promised, I'm gonna be sharing with you today my DIY wedding planner. So how to create your own wedding binder very, very affordably instead of buying one of those expensive pre-made ones from the store, because those ones are very expensive to begin with. And second of all, they might have some sheets that you might not need in there, so it might not be really worth your money. Like for instance, for us, we know that our ceremony portion is gonna be at our church and that our officiant is going to be our pastor. So we don't need a lot of planning sheets in regards to that. For the supplies you need, definitely check your house first, see anything that you already have at hand. Like for me, for instance, when I was in school I was really into school supplies, so I stocked up a lot of stuff when it was like on sale and stuff like that. So I have all the stuff that I'm going to be sharing with you that I already have at home, so I didn't really need to purchase anything. But if you need to go purchase some items, definitely check out the dollar store. I really recommend that, or stores like Target and Walmart. Those are really great options too. And if you really need to, you can check out your local office supply store, like when there's sale and stuff like that, you can pick up a few items. So what you actually need is a binder, as like you see right here. This binder, I don't know exactly how large it is, but I would suggest something 1 to 1.5 inches in size, so that it's not too big, so you actually want to bring it with you everywhere, because you will need to bring it with you when you go visit with your vendors, different venues and things like that. And also, when you have a binder and have everything organized, people are going to take you more seriously, and then they might not overcharge you and things like that, because they know that you're organized on your end. And it's also, especially if you are young and you're trying to get married, it's always good to have this and be organized on your end once again, so then they will know that you are taking this thing really seriously. As for the binder, I like one that has like a slip cover, like as you see right here, so I could put my cover page in the front. If not, you can stick this cover page in the first page inside your binder. Also, other things you might need are dividers. I use 2 sets of dividers because I like all my categories really specific, so I can find things easier. So that's why I have 2 sets of dividers. And this other thing is optional, which is sheet protectors. I personally find it really useful, because I like to flip through my pages back and forth, and I don't want my sheets and papers to rip. So sheet protectors are really great for that. And if you don't want to spend the money on that, then you can just get a couple sheet protectors for things that you really don't want to punch in your planner, like contracts or just little clippings that you find here and there, you know, your wedding dress that you like, or you know, other clippings that you put into here, that you can put them into sheet protectors. So now onto the actual inserts. Most of them I got free printables online, so you can find them very affordably, and they're free, and just print them out on your own. And I also got 1 set from Etsy. I purchased 1 set for the price it was. It gave the most sheets that I found, and most of the sheets I feel like I needed to use them, like I would use them. So that's why I got that. So I thought it was a very good deal. I just bought it on Etsy, and it gave me a file which I printed out, and I can print out as much as I want for personal use. So that's where I got the stuff, and everything I got I will link down in the description box, so you can check those out. So the first section here, which I don't have enough dividers, so there's no tab for this section. And that is some checklists. So it's really good to have checklists, because there's going to be a lot of things you need to do between when you got engaged to your actual wedding day. So I just got a few of them here. So it's good to have a few of them, because different sheets have different things when you need to do them and stuff like that. Certain things that you might have to do this 12 months before your wedding. Some people say you have to do this 11 months before your wedding. So it's good to have some different forms of like these timeline types of checklists. And I'm sorry if some of these fonts are really faint and you can't see much, because I think my boyfriend's laser printer was starting to be out of ink. I don't know, it's like a black and white laser printer. So if some of the font you can't see very faint, I will try to explain as much as I can. So these are just the monthly checklists. This is just a very basic one. It comes in different categories actually. So there's engagement portion, pre-planning, major planning, another column of major planning, attire, and then the rest of your stuff. I also printed out some monthly to-do list sheets. I don't know if I will need them. So checklists, and then some notes on the bottom. What I really like is having a monthly calendar. So if you use a separate planner for that, you can. I just thought it would be nice to have everything written in here, so when I look back, it's kind of like scrapbooking or whatnot, to have all my wedding stuff over here. I do have an Erin Condren life planner. If you do follow me in my YouTube and my Instagram, it's a vertical style, and I will put my appointments and things in there. But I also want to put them in here so I can have this, you know, over here. Especially for the monthly view, I'm going to solely use this. And for my weekly views and stuff, I will use my Erin Condren, like my normal planning. For the notes section, what I did was I compiled a few of these. I just checked and see which one I really needed to do or when I want to do them, and I just put them here. I didn't pre-fill too much of February or onto March, as you see here, because some things might be done sooner rather than later, and once they're done, I don't need to carry it forward to the next thing. But it's good to have these ones here, these checklists over here, so I can still refer back to see what I need to do so I won't forget and stuff like that. So even though I don't pre-fill out what I actually want to do each month. So I got the monthly calendars. I like how these are blank and you can put in your dates, so you can use them whenever. And I also have over here, which is a list of things that you might want to do on the day of your wedding, which I find really, really helpful. I really, really like that. And I will take some of these things if I need to do them. I will put them onto here, which I like this blank itinerary. Right here, as you can see, you can put in your time slots and then you can put in what you want to do. So especially for the day of the wedding, it gets really hectic. It's good to plan hourly increments or even half hour increments what you're doing. If you need to get your hair done, you need to do this and that, so that everybody is on page, on point, on know what you're doing and on the same page. And if they need to refer to where you are, get a hold of you or whatever, it's good to have an itinerary for the day of the wedding. So the next section here is called wedding party. I labeled it as that. It's basically the contact information of all the people in your involved in your wedding, as well as some party information like engagement party, bachelor party, and stuff like that. So this one is just a generic information where you can have all your bridesmaids, groomsmen, best man, and all their information and like their address and everything. Is really handy, so if anyone needs to get a hold of anyone. And this sheet plus this itinerary, I would say on the day of the wedding, needs to go in the front of the planner, so that if people need to know where you are or who's where and need to contact anyone, that will be in the front of the planner. Here is an information of the names of all the wedding party individuals. I know it's on the other one, but this one just a list of the names. Next here are just a whole bunch of detailed information of the people in the party. So the first one is the bride, so me. And I already filled up some of the stuff, which I shouldn't have done because there's personal information, but I just covered it up here so you can't see that. I like how the bottom here has the wedding dress information, so any information about hair color, nails, and whatnot. And then I like that there is a checklist included in each of these sheets. For the bride one, it doesn't really matter because I'm planning my whole wedding on my own anyways. So basically, I'm doing everything. For the groom, I might want to delegate some tasks for my fiance and for the maid of honor again here. And then we have two bridesmaids. So if I want to delegate some tasks to them and once they're done, I can check them off. And also, if there is best man, groomsman. These are how the sheets look like before they fill them out, below they're filled out. And groomsmen. So we basically have two groomsmen, two bridesmaids, one best man, and one maid of honor. And here are some party information. I don't know why I have an engagement party one over here, because we're not doing an engagement party. But basically, they're basically same for bridal shower, bachelor party, and bachelorette party. They just have detailed information once you know for sure what you want and the people you want to invite, if they have RSVP'd or not, and any costs involved on there. So I'm very sorry if you can hear some vacuuming. I think my building manager is vacuuming the hallways and stuff like that, so if you could hear that, I am very, very sorry. I can't control when she does that. Next section is attire, so any clothing, dress related things, any makeup, beauty, anything of that nature. So I have this planning sheet for dresses, so I can write which boutique I've checked out and what are the dresses and the pros and cons of each thing. This is a more detailed version of it. I think this is more when I am actually finalized everything. I can write what I have for shoes, for veil, headpiece, gloves, even shawl, and any dress fitting timings I have here at the bottom. This set is for bridesmaids, for planning their stuff, more bridesmaid planning, size and measurements and stuff, if you want to get custom dresses and stuff like that. I don't know if I will. Might just try to see if I can find some just basic cocktail dresses at some normal non-bridal store, so hopefully that'll be cheaper. But I have a few of those as well. These are for the groomsmen, you know, same kind of deal. And then we also have here the beauty one. This one's for hair. So if any clippings that I want, I can actually stick it over here, this section right here, any hair ideas that I have and whatnot. And then this one is for makeup. This is an accessories planner. This is just basically when I have my idea of makeup, hair, nails, toes, toenails, veil, ring size, jeweler. This is when I have it finalized. I can just write it here. And this is again another, I like how they always have a budget thing over here, so I can see what kind of things I've been spending and then do that, and then put it into the master budget list at the end of the planner. Next section is ceremony, so anything pertaining directly to the ceremony location. So none of my decoration, any of that personal touch to it, just the ceremony location itself, and any contracts that I have for that will be put in here. I just haven't put that in here because I am getting married at my church, but we are still trying to pick between one of two dates, so there's no contracts in here. This first sheet is just a ceremony contract list, so you could put their business card here, or you can write their information over here, and then there is a section on the bottom for notes. So I have the same thing for the officiant, so their information and then some notes. The sheet I really like is the ceremony worksheet, so how you want your ceremony to go about, like who comes in with who, in the processional, you have the recessional, and then you have the ceremony part, so who's going to do lighting of candles, who's going to do reading, singing, all this kind of stuff. The order of things is on this sheet. And the next section is reception, so things pertaining to directly to the reception locations, to the venue where I'm going to have my reception, is on this section. And again, any contracts for the final venue that I'm going to be picking is going to be here, but it's not yet, so it's not in here. But what's really important is to have this sheet. It's from Here Comes the Guide. I really like that sheet, but it's more US-based, so you can actually pick where you want your venue, like different venue options, and there's a lot of things that are really US based, but a lot of these checklists and things are really universal. So here's questions to ask your wedding venue. So venues that you want to check out, especially when venues that don't have a lot of detail in their website, it's good to have this list to see what questions you might want to ask them. If when you meet with them and they don't cover it, it's good to have this so you don't miss out on anything. And then I also have a note section of the questions that I'm going to be asking this first venue we're meeting with this week. So questions I want to ask them about that if they don't cover it, or questions that I have based on what they say on their website so far. So I have a few of those in there. And then this is just the reception, the contact information for the reception itself, and then some note section on the bottom. Here are some seating chart ones that I'm going to use these actually for when I actually know who's going to sit at what table. So we have the rectangle table, circle table, round tables, and then you have your square tables. And it's really good for to have some of this and to just think of if you're actually getting a place where you're renting tables and chairs, or to what you would like, or if you're at a venue where they only have round tables as opposed to square or something like that. So it's good to have this in mind. And then I have just a blank seating plan, just a place where you can put the table number and who you want at each table. And this one's really good because you can just like move people around, because it's always going to be like that until the final numbers and whatnot. So it's good to have that. And there's a little note section in the bottom. So I have a few of these for my planning purposes, and this is for my actual, you know, to put people's names down. This is a rental worksheet. So if you're getting a venue, or you are getting married at a place where you're going to need to rent tables, chairs, and stuff like that, you might want a separate rental section. But because I am going to go with a venue that hopefully will have everything, so I didn't have a separate section for that. But this is just items that you might want to rent, like chairs and tables, lighting, tents you might need if you're doing an outdoor wedding, any glassware, flatware, cutlery, linens, all kinds of things that you might possibly need. And then there's a teardown planner, which I find really important to have, so you'll know who is responsible for taking down what. Because if you choose a venue, they might not necessarily tear down everything, especially if you want to decorate on your own, aside from whatever they provide for you. So it's good to know who does what, or anything you might need to do, or for rental companies to come pick up items and whatnot. And I really like these planning sheets to have these budget sections, so you can have a little budget thing there. Next section is food and drinks. Very self-explanatory. First, it's a caterer's kind of planning sheet. So prospective caterers that I might have, and pros and cons of each if you are going with that route, finding your own caterer. And this is the final caterer planning. So once you know what company you're going with, contact information, budget, also your appetizer, entree, your side dish, your drink options, others, you can plan here. This is when you know more for sure. This is a cake planner sheet. Again, you have different bakeries you're checking out, pros and cons of each cake you've tried and whatnot. This is more detailed information about cakes. If you want a round cake, you want a square cake, you want tiered, you want something on top of your cake or whatever, this is more detailed. There's checklists. So also questions you can ask when you go cake shopping, you can say, I want this, this, and this, or if they ask you and whatnot, you can check it off. Here is the baker's information, so their contact information up here, and then your notes section down here. And this is just a menu worksheet. So what kind of foods you want, and stuff like that, and different checklists. Next section is music and audio visual, I labeled, kind of like my multimedia section. And so musicians and DJs, so their contact information and their and the notes. Perspective music, different kinds of music, pros and cons, kind of like a worksheet here. This one I really like because it just tells you bride and groom song suggestions. And these are song suggestions for your bridal party. So if your bridesmaid would ever have a song suggestion. And this is the greatest part here, is the songs that you do not want at your wedding. For some reason, there's a song you might not want. It's good to have it there because you really don't want it in your wedding. Next is just a generic playlist, so you can have all the lists of your songs and the artists. It's always good to have that. And some note section on the bottom. This one is a music planner. So once you know what you want for your prelude, for your bridal party, first dance, father, daughter, mother, groom, kinds of things. And then if you, some contact information if you're actually using a musician from somewhere or a DJ or whatnot or a band or something. And here's a budget section for that. Next here is a very, very detailed music worksheet. Very, very detailed of what you want for each section of your wedding, what songs you want and stuff. So I really like this, and this is what I'm gonna do for final planning. And I'm gonna use these other sheets for more like a pre-planning, especially this one, because it's just like a list format. And next here I have my photographer, so their contact information and a note section. And I really like this photo shot list of the photos that you might want to get done on your wedding day. It's really good to have this so you'll know for sure that you won't miss out on any certain photos, and you can give this list to your photographer and you can choose the ones that you want. Because certain things, like let's say if your grandparents have passed away, then you don't need to do like groom's photo with groom with grandparents or bride with grandparents or something like that. You can actually cross it off. So this is good as kind of like a basic, so you know, so you can pick and choose what you want photos taken on the day of your wedding. And then the back here is just contact information of your videographer and a note section. Next section is decorations and floral flowers. This is just a florist worksheet, different florists you might want to check out, pros and cons for that. I didn't have any place to put that, so I put that in the slip pocket there. This is your florist information and your some note section down here. This is a detailed decoration or flowers that you might want at your reception, at your a ceremony in different parts, so it's more detailed planning. And this note section, I just put down things that pertain to decorations, so centerpieces, wedding gifts, and cost, and where I can get them, and stuff like that for my own planning. Next is stationery. So I like the stationery planner, very basic, so things that you might need to send, save the dates, invitations, RSVP, bridal shower, stuff like that, how many you need for each, and how many, when do you need to send them by, a little note section. And I like how there's a budget, because there's always budget involved when you're creating your own, or even if you're purchasing cards, there's a budget. And then this is a more detailed version of that, more breakdown of that. This one is actually a wedding invitation worksheet to help you plan your wedding invitation. So like the name of the bride and the groom, the dates, the time, the location, if you want a tagline on your invitation, what you want to write directly on your invitation. This is for that planning purpose. And I have some samples that are printed offline that I actually really like. And I'm gonna create my own wedding invitation and bridal shower invitations and stuff like that. I love doing that kind of stuff, but I'm just not creative and in creating templates off the top of my head or ideas. So I like having these. I might combine a couple of these ideas, so we'll see. And it's okay that you guys are seeing this, because honestly, no one that's gonna be part of my wedding is gonna ever watch my videos, or so far not yet that I know of. So I don't care if they see whatever printables I found. So definitely go online and check out the kind of the stuff that you want, especially if you're creating your own invitations. And this is just a sample of the wedding ceremony, the program sheet. Guest list, this is a basic one with name, address, are they coming and how many, so if they're gonna bring a guest like plus one or whatever. My favorite one for guest list is this one, which gives you their name, address, if they have kids, very detailed information, like their if you have sent them a save the date yet, or if you sent them the invitation, if they RSVP'd yes, or are they going to the bridal shower, engagement party, whatnot. Everything is very detailed. I might need to print more. I have quite a few here, but I still might need to print more of these here. And then the last one is a budget list. It's always good to have a budget, but I put it in the back because obviously you don't want to have like numbers flashing at you everywhere. And a lot of those sheets already have a little small budget section, so that's really good. And it's a master budget list. Before I put everything down into the very detailed one, I put it here. And then if I need to add a few of the items together to make one category and to put in my detail one, that's good. I might do this last. Everything I spend, I would just jot down here or jot down in one of those little boxes on certain sheets that I showed you on the bottom of the box. And there's also a note section here. These are the detailed budget work. Very, very, very detailed. I don't know if you can see. Sorry if the printing is very faint. And some extra sheets that I didn't put in here are the wedding vows. If you want to make your own vows, there are sheets for that. Guest list, gift list, I mean. I think we might do just get people to give us money because we're thinking of buying some few larger items like an armoire and stuff. So we might not do registry. We're still unsure. Dietary needs, it's good to have that if anyone's vegan or gluten-free or whatever. Wish list, things that you might want for your wedding as gifts. And then appointments, if you have a lot of appointments, you might want to use these appointment sheets as well. I don't have my honeymoon in here planned because I don't have enough divider space and this planner is basically maxed out. And so I find that it's actually best that I will put my honeymoon planner in a separate binder because that's not pertaining directly to the wedding. So I hope this video actually helps you in giving you some ideas of what you can put in a wedding binder. These are just some of my ideas. So you can see what works best for you. And I will see you next time. Bye for now.